Why does it take time to be fat adapted when our body already knows how to burn fat?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Wow, we have Ulysses S. Grant as a part of our audience. Cool. Ulysses S. Grant asks, I keep hearing that the body needs time to become fat adapted. Does it know how to burn fat right away? Doesn't it know? I feel like I answered this question last time. Okay. So the body does need time to get fat adapted because, yeah, the body knows how to burn fat, but fat adaptation is not about the body knowing how to burn fat. It's about the body increasing the expression of enzymes involved in burning fat. So everything that you do in the body requires enzymes. Enzymes are proteins that need to be made. Making proteins is an energy-intensive process. All biological organisms try to conserve energy because energy reserves are absolutely critical to biological function. And so whenever you don't need to do something, you tend not to do it. Whenever you do need to do something, you tend to do it. And so your body's going to take signals from your usual diet to see whether it makes sense to make more proteins to be involved in burning fat versus carbohydrate. And as humans, we do this all the time. We plan things. And yeah, there might be some things that we do sort of on autopilot, but the more energy or the more money, which is a signifier of energy reserves, you spent energy to get the money, you held on to the money, you're going to transfer it for some value in the future. The more energy and money things require, the more we think about whether we're going to invest in something, right? And so it doesn't cost a lot of money to drink a glass of water. You're probably going to do it on autopilot. And if you drink a little bit more water than you needed, you're going to maybe pee an extra time, but you don't care. But when it comes time to buy a house with two extra rooms, then you're probably not going to do that unless you have a pretty high probability of needing the room because you're expanding your family. So you probably will do that if on a 2, 3, 4, 5 year time horizon, it makes sense to, and you'll probably not at all do that. Because you don't want to waste the money and time on it if you do not expect to need that room over a 5 year time horizon. And you can pick something over a 6 month time horizon or a 1 month time horizon or 1 year time horizon. There are innumerable examples where as humans, we, you know, if something is going to take effort, we're going to think about whether it makes sense and we're going to plan accordingly. So your body's doing the exact same thing. It's going to increase enzymes involved in fat digestion and metabolism if you've been eating fat. And because it's expensive to do that, it's going to cut back on them if you haven't been eating fat. All right, Ulysses, I hope that helps answer your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book.
In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.